salam performs salat in accordance with the Sharia which came down to Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. And then at the end of the salat, he declares, open the gates. Because the masjid is barricaded. Damascus is facing serious violence. An Israeli invasion has taken place. Israeli troops are on the ground, led by Dajjal. And so, history is going to end. Not the end of the world. Eh? Nobody knows the end of the world. Don't make that mistake. Nobody knows the end of the world. I'm talking about the end of history, not the end of the world. History is going to end with Damascus playing a central role. Nabi Isa alayhi salam is inside the masjid. Imam al-Mahdi is inside the masjid. Dajjal is outside. The three most important actors in Akhiru Zaman are all three right there in the same place at the same time. Imam al-Mahdi, Nabi Isa alayhi salam, and Al-Masih al-Dajjal, all three. He says, open the gates. The gates are open. And he comes out, Nabi Isa alayhi salam. And Dajjal sees him. Today, the Zionists are attacking Gaza with missiles from the air. Brutal attacks like beasts, killing innocent people, starving a people, blockading Gaza. Oppression at its worst. But tomorrow, they're going to be on the run. And this lecture is delivered to tell you that. فَلَا تَهِنُوا. So don't give up. Don't despair. وَتَدْعُوا إِلَى السَّلْمِ. And don't go begging for peace. وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ. When you should be struggling to have the upper hand. وَاللَّهُ مَعَكُمْ. And Allah is with you in that struggle. وَلَيْ يَتِرَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ. And Allah will not allow your effort to be wasted in vain. As soon as Dajjal sees Nabi Isa alayhi salam, he melts like salt melts in water. That is the state of fright. And he takes off, running. And Nabi Isa alayhi salam pursues him. They don't like to hear this part of the lecture. And he overtakes him in a place called Lud, and he kills him with a spear. And then he lifts the spear to show the blood. Dajjal, of course, is going to appear at that time as a human being, a human being. And he would be a Jew. And he would be a young man. And he would be powerfully built. And I used to say he would have curly hair. Until an Egyptian student of mine said to me, "No, Sheikh, you're wrong. The Prophet is talking about the curls that the Orthodox Jews have on their side. This is what he's talking about." So Dajjal will be like the Orthodox Jews with the curls on the side. That's what he means by curly hair. When he is killed, Dajjal now passes into non-existence. It is after that killing of the Dajjal that we come to Gog and Magog. We'll continue inshallah after Salatul Isha. Bismillahi awwaluhu wa akhiruhu.